This video aims to delve deeper into the use case product carbon footprint. Measuring GHG emissions for vehicles is challenging due to the complexity of the global automotive supply chain, where many different materials and parts are sourced from various companies and locations to ensure supply chain resilience and risk management. And with the increasing shift toward electrification in the automotive industry, the production phase has become a more substantial contributor to a vehicle's product carbon footprint compared to its utilization phase. As a result, companies want to find ways to reduce their impact on the footprint. Reported product carbon footprints may vary significantly among companies, even for identical parts and processes, leading to inconsistencies in GHG accounting. These variations do not stem from actual differences, but rather arise from the diverse application of GHG accounting practices, meaning it allows for significant room for interpretation when measuring PCF values. Now, as companies align with climate goals and seek to become more environmentally friendly, they will rely on PCFs to determine where they buy their parts and materials. So these numbers need to be accurate and comparable. Existing GHG accounting standards like ISO 14040, 14044, 14067, the GHG Protocol Product Standard, and others are not specific enough, leading to inconsistent application among companies. Hence, reporting among companies is also inconsistent and incomparable for companies, regulators, investors, and consumers. Also, these guidelines often rely on industry-wide averages, not specific to each company, so we can't see the differences between individual companies very well. In simple terms, measuring and standardizing product carbon footprints in the automotive industry is tough, and it is crucial to address the complexity of supply chains, reduce inconsistencies, and support environmentally responsible decision-making. This is why Catena-X has developed a rulebook with the primary objective of reducing interpretation, establishing consistency across the supply chain, and enabling informed decision-making, particularly in the selection of parts and materials. Let's take a moment to look into two important aspects. All emissions allocated to a product upstream of a company, including emissions resulting from processes within the company until the product leaves the manufacturer's gate, are covered in what we call the cradle-to-gate PCF. PCF represents the total GHG emissions generated during a product's life cycle, measured in CO2 equivalents. However, it is important to note that the Catena-X PCF rulebook excludes product use and end-of-life stages from the PCF calculations. Currently, the practice of accounting for product carbon footprints is primarily adopted by larger companies. To make this accounting approach more accessible to smaller companies, the Catena-X rulebook will balance applicability and comparability of PCF accounting. It will gradually introduce more complex rules and provide guidance materials. Cooperation with small and medium-sized enterprises will also be strengthened in the future. Let's unite to lower GHG emissions and create a new standard for the future of the global automotive industry.